While I'm thinking about it, let me jump back over to this template here. I'll give you another couple of cool tips. Here's a time and frustration saving tip for working with some of these advanced templates in PowerPoint to make video files, right? So primarily, these are awesome, and what you're going to end up doing is kind of modifying them. So we can modify text and stuff, and that's no big deal. And it's basically going to boil down to things like editing pictures, right? And swapping them out for ones that we want to use. And also maybe playing with some of the animations. So the punchline is, there's a couple of features in PowerPoint that we as video creators, especially working with more complex templates, love some templates because there's a lot of work already done here, but there's a couple features that we will primarily focus on. If you use templates like this, you're going to need to know about two things, the selection pane and the animation pane, right? Because that's what all these things are about. They're about animations and a bunch of stuff that you can modify and play with. So here's the thing you kind of need to know how to get to those things. For example, to get to the selection pane, which will show me all the layers and all the stuff, you can go to the Home tab, and then way over here under Select, you can use the drop down arrow and you can go to the selection pane. Here's all the stuff I might want to modify on this slide. Okay, so that's cool. You can also get to the selection pane by clicking on anything on the slide, go to Format, and the selection pane is right here. So there's a couple ways to hunt and peck and go and try to open up your selection pane. Let me give you a little tip here. I'm going to use this method right now. I'm going to click on anything, go to the Format tab, and boom, there's my selection pane. As a video creator using PowerPoint, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to right click on this guy and I'm going to say Add to Quick Access Toolbar. Right? See this guy up here? I'm customizing my toolbar to be more video creation centric. Right? So now instead of going, oh, is it on Home? And then under select, right? Instead of doing all that garbage or even clicking on anything and having to go to the Format tab, you just go boom, there it is, right? And it's just handy dandy, and you click it again and it goes away, or you can exit it out. So that's one that just saves a whole bunch of time. Put the stuff that we as video creators use, boom, right here, and always have it. And you don't have to be stabbing all over the place. So the other thing is the animation pane. So let's click on animations here, and here's the animation pane, and this shows me all the animations that are going to happen. Okay, so sometimes we'll be moving stuff around or playing with timing or, any number of things that we might want to modify, or even just to preview the animations. Okay? That kind of thing. Well, I can do the same trick. Once I'm on the Animations tab, right click on this guy and say Add to Quick Access Toolbar. Now, no matter where I am, wherever you are, you're on your Transitions tab, or I got to go to Animations and open the Animation pane. This one happens a lot. Seriously, just a ton. So you always got to go to the Animations tab and open the Animations pane. Well, or you can just do this. Boom. Right? There you go. Okay, so is that a good tip? Good quick tip? If you're a video maker, get these two guys up here. Quit screwing around, wandering all over the place. It's going to save you a bunch of time. All right.